The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
Men's health, penis problems. This is a very important topic and many of you wonder about whether your penis is healthy, whether it's normal, right, about its size, shape, etc., etc., etc. But there is more than that, right? See, penis health involves obviously around erection, but you need to find out what are the most common penis problem and what are the strategy, what is the most important thing which you need to know to keep it healthy, right? Obviously, penis is an important part of your health and it goes much beyond than just keeping an erection or ejaculation or reproduction, right? And problems of the penis can actually be a sign of underlying health condition, diseases, and therefore you need to know about it, right? Even your existing diseases, health condition can affect your penis and cause problems. Moreover, these problems can affect your life in a bad way, putting you in stress, your relationships in problem, it can actually hamper your self-confidence, and every single part of your life can be affected. So that's why it's very important for you to know about the signs and symptoms of penis-related problems and what can you do to protect your penis, right? So let's talk about the most common penis problems, right? Obviously, there are some factors which you can change. There are some things which you cannot change in your body. For example, number one is unprotected sex. If you do unprotected sex, obviously you have a risk of sexually transmitted diseases. So you can change that. You can use a condom. But second thing which is there is your smoking. If you smoke, obviously your blood vessels in every single part of your body become constricted, become hardened. There are so many side effects. We have talked about smoking in various videos, in dedicated videos as well, right? So if you are a smoker, then you have much higher chances of having erectile dysfunction very soon. Secondly, same thing applies to heart disease patients. Patients with diabetes, patients with high blood pressure, they also have a higher chance of erectile dysfunction. Plus, there are certain medicines which have side effects on your penis as erectile dysfunction. And certain surgeries, certain medical treatments, like if you have a surgery around your penis, say if you have a prostatectomy, if you have any urinary incontinence or some surgery around the urethra, then also you might have problems with your penis health, right? Then hormone levels are very important. Everybody knows that if there is a testosterone deficiency, it is definitely linked to erectile dysfunction. And do you know, even obesity can result in lower testosterone level. We already talked about this in details in the testosterone video. If you haven't watched that, don't forget to watch it. But a big factor here is psychological factor. Yes. See, if you actually experience an erectile problem, then you might be afraid or concerned that it will happen again. And this causes anxiety, this causes performance stress, depression. This can lead to a totally whole lot of a further another level and cause problems and increase your erection problem, right? And getting older, if you are aging, that also causes erectile dysfunction, obviously, as you become older and older. And testosterone levels also becomes less as you become, you know, as your age increases. So that needs to be considered here. You cannot change that, but there are things which you can change, right? Like increasing your testosterone levels naturally. For that, you can watch my video on testosterone. Then piercings is another thing, right? Penis piercings are also something which people do, and these things can lead to skin infections, right? They can also disrupt the urinary flow, and they can lead to urinary tract infections. Also, depending upon where the piercing is placed, it might also worsen your ability to actually achieve an erection or an orgasm. So, and there is also one more factor. If you do a masturbation, a big factor, people think about this all the time, but right, and even aggressive or kind of acrobatic sex, very aggressive sex, right? So if during this process, if penis is bent suddenly or very forcibly while it's erect, then rarely, but it is possible that you can actually cause a penis fracture. It's possible, right? And this can also lead to permanent curvature of the penis. And this can, but remember, even if there is a curvature, that does not have to mean it has to be a fracture, right? But masturbation, right? People have so many questions on masturbation. That's why we made a video dedicated to masturbation. Quite frankly, masturbation does not cause a problem in penis or its health, or for that matter, erectile dysfunction. Unless and until you are habituated or addicted to masturbation and you are doing it so often that your actual health, your actual mind is only on masturbation. That kind of becomes an obsessive, compulsive masturbation. Still, your penis will be overused but not damaged. Remember this, right? So that is one important thing. Then there are conditions that can actually evolve inside your penis, right? Number one is obviously erection problem. So erectile dysfunction, we have already made a detailed video, but this can be associated with painful erection. That is also a possible thing, having erections with pain, and that is not caused by sexual stimulation, right? This is called priapism, right? Arousal, that is a different thing. This can be a side effect of medicines or certain condition. It can happen. You need to contact a doctor if that is the case. And other concerns in ejection is if you are unable to ejaculate, if there is delayed ejaculation, ejaculate is not happening, or if there is a premature ejaculation, it's happening so fast, or there is a painful ejaculation is happening, but that you are having pain, right, during that, or reduced ejaculation, that is also there, that the quantity is decreased, retrograde ejaculation, that means it's, you are feeling that ejaculation is happening, but it's not coming out, rather it drops back inside your urinary bladder. Retrograde ejaculation is also possible, right? And these are the problems which can happen in the ejaculation process, right? Any problem, you might be having any of these problems. So all of them need evaluation, right? Then there is something called as anorgasmia. What is that? This is, in some cases, men might not be able to achieve an orgasm despite of adequate stimulation, obviously. This might be because of hormonal problems such as low testosterone, or there might be some underlying problem in your nerves, right? Or even medicines or diseases like diabetes can lead to this kind of condition. Then there is problems of libido changes, reduced desire of sex, libido. This is the thing. This can happen in several conditions like hormone imbalance, relationship issues. You don't have a good verbal relationship with your spouse. Even because of depression, you can have decreased libido. There is significant, and if you have very much abrupt decrease or increase in libido, they both are problematic. Right? Abrupt increase or decrease, they both can be pathological. Particularly if there is increase in older men, right, suddenly, then it might be due to substance abuse, some kind of substance which you are using, or some conditions which are affecting your brain, right? Brain controls everything. So if brain is firing signals for stimulation suddenly, then there is a problem. There might be a tumor, there might be something else, right? Then you can actually discuss this changes of your abrupt changes of desire with your doctor. This is also an important thing, right? Then there are obviously infections. We've talked about sexually transmitted infections like genital warts, gonorrhea, chlamydia, syphilis, genital herpes, right? All these things are there. And The common signs of symptoms of this kind of problems are painful urination, penis discharge through the penis, and there will be soreness or blisters on your penis. There will be sores, blisters on the penis or in the genital area. If you find these kind of things, then you need to talk to a doctor. And there can be problems with the foreskin of your penis, right? This condition is known as phimosis. Phimosis means when the foreskin obviously is uncircumcised, of an uncircumcised penis, cannot be retracted back from the penis head. That if it is just outside, it cannot be retracted, then it is called phimosis, and this can lead to infections, right? And it can also cause painful urination as well as painful erections. So phimosis can be problematic. And there is something called as paraphimosis. This occurs when the foreskin is retracted back, which cannot return to the normal position. That is paraphimosis, right? This condition can cause painful swelling of the head of the penis, and this can be because of the impaired blood flow, because of that pressure around the neck of the penis. So remember, then there are other diseases and conditions, like you can have infection, like yeast infection, which can cause a red rash or a white patch, red rash or white patch on your penis, and there can be inflammation of the head of the penis, which is called balanitis, head of the penis, inflammation, balanitis. This can cause pain as well as a foul smelling discharge, right? There is something called as Peyronie's disease, which is a condition in which there is a development of abnormal scar tissue inside the penis, right? This can lead to a bent penis, right? This can lead to a bent penis or can lead to painful erections, right? This is a chronic condition. It is a scar inside the penis, right? This is called Peyronie's disease, right? Then there is a chance of cancer in the penis. Yes, penile cancer, which can happen as a blister, right, on the foreskin. You might have a blister on the head or the shaft of the penis. Then it becomes, it grows like a wart, and then there is that this growth can have discharges, watery discharge or pus discharge. This is a rare thing, okay, but it's possible, right? So you need to know about it. So all these things can happen on your penis. So what you need to do, right? If there is any change in the way you ejaculate, if there is a bleeding through your urination or ejaculation during that time, if there are warts, bumps, lesions or rashes on your penis, or in your genital region, or if there is a penis which is severely bent, or that has curvature is causing pain, or if it interferes with your sexual activity, you have to go to a doctor. Or maybe if there is a burning sensation in your when you're urinating, or maybe there is a discharge from your penis, there is a severe pain, or there is a trauma, actual trauma to your penis, then also there is a problem. Any abrupt increase in sexual desire, particularly older men, any significant decrease in the sexual desire, you should go to a doctor. So these are all the problems which can happen with your penis. And what can you do? What are the eight steps, eight key things, eight professional tips which you can do to your health to keep your penis healthy? It's very important. Number one is be sexually responsible. Be sexually responsible. Use a condom, right? Use a condom or maintain a natural monogamous relationship. It's important, right? Either use a condom if you have multiple sexual partners, or have single sexual partner, right? Monogamous relationship with a partner who has been tested, right? Or is free from sexually transmitted diseases, obviously. That is one thing. Second, you should get vaccinated. Now, yes, if you are 26, if your age is 26 or younger, you can consider getting vaccinated for HPV. Human papilloma virus. Now this vaccine helps prevent genital warts. It's an important thing, right? You can talk to your gynecologist for that. And then Stay physically active. Third thing is to case, because even moderate physical activity can significantly reduce your chances of erectile dysfunction, right? And practice good hygiene. It's very important. If you're not circumcised, then regularly clean the beneath part of your foreskin with soap and water, and make sure to return the foreskin to the normal position after cleaning or after sex. It's important, right? Then know your medicines. If you're taking any medicines, you should talk to your doctor about the side effects of your medicine if you're facing any side effects, right? Pay attention to your mental health, right? Seek treatment for depression or any mental condition if you have. If you're smoking, then limit the amount of alcohol and stop smoking. That is very, very important. And make healthy choices, right? Maintain a good healthy weight. Make sure to reduce your weight if you are obese. Good sleep. Control your blood pressure, your diabetes. Good healthy lifestyle. Good healthy sleep. A lot of fluids. It's important to maintain a good health as well as a healthy penis. So this is all about penis health. I hope this video was helpful. Make sure to share this video and let me know your comments down below. I'm Dr. Paramjit. You're watching Dr. Education. Stay connected. Stay healthy.